Is cloning a disk a viable backup strategy? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got. Leo, I've reformatted my PC several times in the past, which is a real pain. Since then, I've done things a little different. Now I just use another internal hard drive to clone my present hard drive. It takes less than an hour to do so, and I do this every 6 months using flash drives in between to save anything new. It seems to work well for me. Can you think of problems that may occur from doing this sort of backup? Yes, I can. But first, backing up at all puts you well ahead of the game. Good on you for doing this. From the people I hear, you're probably doing better than half of the people that I hear from. Now, cloning your hard drive can be a reasonable solution, but there are a few gotchas, and your approach has some concerns as well. So first, we need to define exactly what the heck a clone is. For this discussion, I take cloning a disk to mean an absolutely identical copy of one hard disk to another. That includes copying the free space, which contains data, it's just marked as unused space, as well as the actual layout or fragmentation of the data on the original disk. That's as compared to an image backup, which contains only the data actually stored on the disk. An image could be used for this, but most people think of clone for the scenario you're considering. So, every so often, you clone your primary hard disk to another, presumably identical hard disk, also installed in your machine. If something happens to the primary, you swap a couple of cables, and the clone becomes the primary, and you're back in business. Sounds nifty. All right, gotcha number one. My biggest concern, you're going to forget. This is doing everything manually, from the every 6 months to the every so often to your flash drives. Even with the best of intentions, you will forget. And for some reason, it seems fate loves to intervene at exactly the wrong time. So you'll likely forget at exactly the time you'll later wish you hadn't, and will end up not having backed up everything you would have wanted to. So to begin with, automate the cloning process. Most cloning tools will let you do that. Once a day, once a week, once a month, whatever. Just make sure that your memory, your personal memory, not your computer memory, isn't directly involved. The same is true for your manually copying things to a flash drive in between. There are two issues there. One is, again, you'll forget. And two, how do you know what to copy? The second part isn't really as frivolous as you might think. You'll say, well, my data, of course. Do you know with absolute certainty where all of your data resides and what all needs to be copied? Might you want more than just your data, like settings or support files that can change between clones? Any kind of manual operation that requires you to look for updated files or relies on your memory of what you did is error-prone. It just is. It's all too easy to overlook a file that you needed to back up. This is typically where I recommend a periodic image backup with a daily incremental. That way, everything is included and your personal memory is again not involved. Gotcha number two. I don't like the location of that second drive. Placing it inside the computer, well, it's nice and all. I suppose it's faster to copy to and there's nothing outside the box to take up space, but some class of problems that happen inside the box could affect both drives at the same time, rendering both your primary and your backup drives toast. The classic scenario is a power spike, taking out the original hard disk and the clone in one zap. The concern here is just that the clone remains vulnerable to various forms of failure that could be the results of the very types of issues that you're trying to protect yourself from. Gotcha number three. I'm a little concerned about how often you're cloning the drive. No matter how you're backing up, every 6 months seems like a really long time between full backups. At a minimum, if I had to change nothing else, I'd have you do your clone a tad more often, perhaps once a month, and then perhaps do those manual copies to a flash drive once a week or more often as well. But honestly, that's not my recommendation at all. I would recommend that instead of cloning, You use an image backup software like Macrium Reflect or Isis To Do or any of several others. Then have these tools configured to automatically save a monthly complete image backup to an external hard drive and save a daily incremental backup to that same external hard drive. That way you'll know for certain that everything is backed up, that it would be on the external drive protects you from some of those shared inside the box risks. I would then use that second internal drive you've got for additional space or speed instead of using it as a backup drive. And I said at the beginning that your backing up is wonderful. You're way ahead of the game. While I would prefer that you do things somewhat differently so as to avoid some of the gotchas I've talked about, you're already protected more than most. But you might want to consider some changes. For updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/9960. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.